Hello everybody, my name is Vinay Jacob John. Please visit my three gospel websites, JesusHealsMinistries.org, PrayInTongues.org, and also PeopleOfJesus.org. Today I want to read about marriage, and the first story is how Isaac meets Rebecca. Genesis chapter 24. Father Abraham was old, well stricken in age. The Lord Jehovah Jesus, Holy Spirit, had blessed Father Abraham in all things. And Father Abraham said unto his eldest servant, Put I pray thee thy hand under my thigh, and I will make you swear by the Lord Jehovah Jesus, Holy Spirit, the God of heaven, the God of the earth, Jehovah Jesus, Holy Spirit, that you go to my country and to my kindred and take a wife for my son Isaac. Verse 7. The Lord God of heaven, Jehovah Jesus, Holy Spirit, spake to me, saying, Unto thy seed Jesus will I give this land. Jehovah shall send Jehovah's angel before you, and you shall take a wife for my son from there. And so the servant put his hand on the father Abraham's thigh and swear to him concerning this matter. And Abraham's servant journeyed to the place, the city of Nahor, and he said, Lord God Jehovah, God of my master father Abraham, behold, I stand here by the well of water, and let it come to pass that the damsel to whom I shall say, Let down thy pitcher, I pray thee, that I may drink, and then she says, Also, drink also, and I will give thy camels drink also. Let it be her that she should be the one appointed for my master Isaac. And then I will know that you have shown kindness to my master. And so Rebecca came out. Rebecca was born to Bethuel, son of Milcah, wife of Nahor, Abraham's brother. Rebecca came out with a pitcher upon her shoulder. Rebecca, the damsel, was very fair to look upon, a virgin. No man had known her. And she went to the well, filled her pitcher, and came. And the servant ran to meet her, Rebecca, and said, Let me, I pray thee, drink a little of thy water. And she said, Drink, my lord. And she gave drink for the servant's camels also. And the servant asked Rebecca, Whose daughter art thou? Tell me, I pray thee. And Rebecca said unto him, I am the daughter of Bethuel, the son of Milcah, which she bare unto Nahor. And so Rebecca tells her house, her brother and her mother, that this man has come from our father Abraham to get a wife for his son Isaac. Verse 51, Behold, Rebecca is before thee, take her and go, and let her be thy master's son's wife, or Abraham's son, Isaac's wife, Rebecca, as the Lord our God, Jehovah, Jesus, Holy Spirit, has spoken. And they called Rebecca and said unto her, Will thou go with this man? She said, I will go. And they sent away Rebecca, their sister. And they blessed Rebecca and said unto her, Thou art our sister Rebecca. Be thou the mother of thousands of millions, let thy seed Jesus possess the gate of those which hate them. 62. And Isaac came from the way of the well, the high Roy, for he dwelt in the south country. And Isaac went up to meditate in the field at the evening, and he lifted up his eyes and saw, and behold, the camels were coming. And Rebecca lifted up her eyes, and when she saw Isaac, she lighted off the camel. For she has said unto the servant, What man is this that walks in the field to meet us? And the servant said, It is my master Isaac. Therefore she took a veil and covered herself. And the servant told Isaac all things that he had done. And Isaac brought her to his mother Sarah's tent and took Rebekah. And Rebekah became his wife, Isaac's wife. And Isaac loved her. Isaac was comforted after his mother's death. And also Isaiah chapter 54 verse 5, For thy maker is thine husband, Jehovah Jesus Holy Spirit. The Lord of hosts is his name, Jehovah Jesus Holy Spirit. And our Redeemer Jesus, the Holy One of Israel, Jehovah Jesus Holy Spirit. The God of the whole earth shall he be called, Jehovah Jesus Holy Spirit. Ephesians chapter 5 verse 18, Be filled with the Holy Spirit till overflowing in excess. Be filled with the Holy Spirit in excess till overflowing. Verse 19, Speaking to yourselves in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing and making melody in your heart to the Lord Jesus, giving thanks always for all things unto God and the Father, Jehovah, in the name of our Lord Jesus and the Holy Spirit, submitting yourselves one to another in the fear of God, Jehovah, Jesus, Holy Spirit. Verse 22, Wives, submit yourselves unto your own husbands as unto the Lord Jesus. For the husband is the head of the wife, even as Christ Jesus is the head of the church, and Jesus is the Savior of the body. Therefore, as the church is subject unto Christ Jesus, so let the wives be to their own husbands in everything. Husbands, love your wives, even as Christ Jesus also loved the church and gave yourself for the church, Jesus, that you, Jesus, might sanctify and cleanse the church with the washing of water by your word. Jesus is the word of God. When God speaks, it is Jesus and the Holy Spirit. That Jesus may present the church to yourself, a glorious church, not having spot or wrinkle or any such thing, but that the church should be holy and without blemish. Verse 28, So ought men to love their wives as their own bodies. He that loveth his wife loveth himself. For no man ever yet hated his own flesh, but nourishes and cherishes it, even as the Lord Jesus the church. For we are members of Jesus' body, of Jesus' flesh and of Jesus' bones. Verse 31, For this cause shall a man leave his father and mother, and shall be joined unto his wife, and they two shall become one flesh. 32, This is a great mystery, but I speak concerning Christ Jesus and the church. Nevertheless, let every one of you in particular so love his wife even as himself, and the wife see that she reverence her husband. Hebrews chapter 13 verse 4, Marriage is honorable in all, and the bed undefiled. But whoremongers and adulterers, God, Jehovah, Jesus, Holy Spirit, will judge. Verse 8, Jesus Christ the same, yesterday and today and forevermore. Amen. Thank you all for listening to me today. Jesus loves us all, Jesus heals us all, Jesus provides for us all. Always, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, Amen.